Hello everyone, Chef Jitsu here. Welcome to or back to my channel, whichever the case may be. I'm bringing you another session of iPlay games, and today I am playing DCS World. DCS stands for Digital Combat Simulator. It's free to play on Steam. Well, it works weird, strange, but I suggest you check it out to see what I'm talking about. Maybe I'll go into more detail. But here we go. Su-25T Frogfoot, the free plane, and I'm just doing the like single mission dogfight against two A-10 warthogs. Start you in a head-on.
Fuel 1500.
They are buzzing right by me. I am using TrackIR as well, so I'm able to free look around. So my thought process here is altitude. Even though I'm in a jet, I know it's not a World War II fighter, but altitude is still advantage. So as they pass by me, they're going to have to turn, burn off some of that energy, and then climb to meet me, which burns off even more energy. So hopefully I can get a good altitude advantage on them and maintain my speed. Alright, and while I'm doing that and working my way back into position, I'm just going to try to circle around them, see what they're going to do, see how they're going to react. As I was explaining, this is free on Steam. You get the Su-25T Frogfoot. Oh my gosh. You get the Frogfoot. Su-25T Frogfoot. This jet that I'm in right now. You get this for free. It comes with its own campaign. It's got a few single-player missions, or single missions that were player-created, I guess. I don't know. And it's also got a really, really hefty campaign and mission editor, so you can have endless amounts of fun if you're into that type of thing. The one thing that's got me hung up is the way that they sell the content for it is you buy like another plane. Some of those planes, even though they come with their own little campaign and whatnot, are $50. So ouch. But you could look at it like you're buying an old school game. You know, like I'm just gonna throw Top Gun out there on Nintendo. Paid. Nowadays, it would have paid $50 for a game like that. It's only the one jet, the one jet, one mission, one or campaign. So, I don't know. But this is just a free version. Okay, I'm rolling in on a target here. Enfield 12. Many G's, get some tone, switch to cannons. Don't have a proper angle. And he hit his air brakes, wants me to go whizzing by. But I'm having none of that. I'm gonna pull up, roll around, slot in on his tail again. But not only does this plane not handle like I would think that it does? It's a really heavy plane. It's an attack, ground attack airplane, or jet. But I just expected it to have a little more oomph than it does. So I start to lose control. I don't get the slot. And I happen to lose my target. Now they're both on my tail. I'm pulling high G's, that's the warning that you hear going off.
Minimum
and here
speed.
I try to go old school.
Minimum speed.
But it doesn't quite work
minimum
as well as
speed.
I thought. Or
minimum speed.
I try an old school hammerhead, go up
minimum
and stall
speed.
Myself out, and roll
minimum
back
speed.
Down. For a first attempt, eh, it worked. I didn't crash. But again, the plane does not handle like I thought it would. Cannot pull up out of this dive fast enough to take advantage of it. I do get a burst off of the cannons, but miss the target. Trying to change angles. I really just don't want him on my rear end. Because he's diving away, I'm trying to roll back into him. Really, the chess game has just begun. I end up getting a nice angle on him. Dropping in, trying to get lined up. This is where things could have went horribly wrong. I'm just trying. He rolls into me. Thank goodness I started with the burst of the cannon at that same time, took off his wing, and flew right through it. Oh man, that was an intense little moment. That's one enemy splashdown. Trying to roll in. And engage target number two. I really was quite lucky there. In numerous ways. If those were players, I'm sure I would have been dead. Did not realize this guy was coming at me in a head-on. See, a mistake here too. Instantly, I start banking into him. Dipping my nose down, trying to maintain energy in the turn. And since I'm not in a prop plane, it's not a huge concern, but I still do want to maintain as much energy as possible. Because these warthogs, I'm sure they're not very maneuverable, but they seem to be outmaneuvering the frogfoot. I've been having a lot of fun with this simulator because, man, this is the most realistic as far as you control every aspect of the plane. Man, I am lucky he did not get a good line on me. Thought about rolling around and looping into him, but it wasn't gonna happen. So I just aileron roll, try to get myself back into a straight level flight, gain some more speed, then turn back around into him since he continued past me and didn't turn back into me. Get some tone, but I was not leading him at all. But I have no experience. These are really the first missiles I've fired. Got a nice little spurt, missed him again. Don't want to burn past him. So I try the same little trick I did on the last guy, but he's stuck with me. He pulled up with me.
Minimum speed.
Maintain the same speed. Starts trying to get me to go into a scissors with him, and I'm not going to have that because there you go. See, he's just able to turn better than I am, and that's not going to end well. So I dip my nose down a little bit, jam on the thrusters, gain some distance, some separation, then I turn back into him. Again, I put myself in a bad spot right there. I'm lucky he was not able to line up for the shot. Trying to get a high yo-yo on him. But I rolled the wrong way. This was horrible. I just didn't do any of this maneuver right. Lost my target, panicked there for a second. He actually had a little more energy than I thought he did. He gained a little more altitude than I thought he'd be able to. Again, he just keeps cutting into me at the right time. Tried to lead. Didn't have enough to lead, though. He was able to avoid another missile fire, and again I put myself in a bad spot right there. Do the same thing I did before. I realize that's not going to end well if I continue that set of maneuvers. Just dip my nose down, gain some speed, gain some distance. Try to loop into him again. I lost him. Pretty sure he was just in that bar. Yeah. Had I not lost visual, I may have been able to slot in on him, but I don't know. Just put a little more distance between him and I than I wanted. This time I thought I had good lead, but he was coming into me.
Fuel 800.
Turning into me. Don't even, not gonna go back there, not gonna touch that one again. Again, try with the high. Well, actually, this is more of a, what do you call it, a clover? When you go up, usually you spin, go vertical, aileron roll 90. That was more of a 180. But it's supposed to help you get behind an enemy that can turn better than you. And here I'm just trying it again, trying to figure out the angles so that when I drop down, I'm dropping down on top and behind. Just missed him with that cannon burst. He's burning away from me again. I'm able to roll in. Can't hear it, but I've got tone. Fire. Solid hit. Oh man, that put him down. Alright, well, I'm pretty sure I'll probably post some more footage from this game. And definitely have some of the DLC $40 content. FW190D, Dora, oh, I want that plane. Anyway, thank you all for watching. Thank you all for spending your time with me. And like I always say, fly high, keep your heads on a swivel, and I will see you on those digital fields of battle.